Dugout News YouTube channel is what you're watching, guys. Welcome aboard. We're talking boxing and got some new news for you in that regard. Now, Radivoje Kalajdzic says Artur Beterbiev sucks the soul out of you. Radivoje Kalajdzic is a man who loves his work. The fighter they call Hot Rod is living his best life, even coming off a hard-fought August 3rd loss to David Morrell. While Kalajdzic felt he deserved more credit on the scorecards in Los Angeles, the St. Petersburg, Florida resident is hoping his performance was strong enough to land him another a big fight. Well, I enjoy this, said Kalajdzic, asked of his continued motivation. I enjoy sparring, fighting, I do everything. So once I lose a love for it, I'm going to retire. But it's like a job for me, but a job that I love. It's putting food, putting money on the table and food for my family. So, like I said, I'm boxing and fighting and I'm getting paid for it. So I can't complain. The married father of three, two girls and a boy aged 9, 6 and 5 has put himself in the frame for a fight with David Benavidez later this year. And he clearly has plenty of respect for the Mexican monster. Yeah, I feel like he throws his punches good. He's very fast, admitted the Serbian native. I feel like he has a really good inside game. But I feel like Caleb Plant showed the first 5-6 rounds that he can be outboxed. But eventually, Plant got tired and then Benavidez started planning implementing his game plan of the night. Regardless, it's going to be a good fight if me and him fight. Benavidez is coming off a points win over a tough and conditioned Ukrainian former champion, Alexander Vodok, in June. It was a tougher fight than many felt it might have been. Did that mean that Benavidez might not be the same force at 175 as he was at super middleweight? Or was it a matter of Vodok having more left than many believed he did? Well, Vodok, he's got maybe plenty left, said Hot Rod. I don't know if he has plenty left. Maybe he does. Vodok has a great amateur experience. He's fought so many professional fighters and he got experience and he knew how to weather the storm, stay calm. And after Benavidez kind of punched himself out, Vodok started coming back. I mean, even Vodok was beating Artur Beterbiev, I think, like until the 9th, 10th rounds. It was a close fight. But I think Vodok was up. But like I said, Beterbiev will eventually get you tired and slow you down. That pressure for 12 rounds, it's hard to deal with. And if he dealt that with Beterbiev, Benavidez is nowhere a monster or puncher like Beterbiev. If Kalajdzic has plenty of respect for Benavidez, he uses it for Beterbiev, who is the only man to stop him. They have sparred before too, and Beterbiev bested him over 5 rounds in 2019, becoming the only man to stop Kalajdzic in his 32-fight career. Well, I see him do to people inspiring is just crazy. 33-year-old adds, he just, he won't even throw punches that much in 2-3 rounds and people are just gassed out just because he's just in front of your face and just doesn't stop coming. Just his presence, his pressure, he's the real deal. Kalajdzic also believes Beterbiev will be victorious in the Showpiece October fight in Riyadh when Beterbiev bids to unify the titles at 175 against Dmitriy Bivol. I think Artur Beterbiev will win, predicted Kalajdzic, just because of his strength, his aggression, and he's a very good boxer. Even though he brawls and he hits hard, he breaks you down round by round. He just sucks the soul out of you, you could say. I sparred him plenty of times, and even in a fight, it's like I was training with him in a fight, and so he doesn't hit that hard, but he just breaks you down and just gets you tired, and eventually he's going to stop you and break you. Does Kalajdzic think the unification fight will deliver on the hype and expectation? Well, every fight that Beterbiev has, it's a damn near fight of the year. He makes you fight his fight, so it's really going to be interesting to see if Bivol can stay away from him for 12 rounds. Kalajdzic hopes he will be back in the mix with a significant name before the end of the year. He would also happily travel to the UK to fight its leading fighters at light heavyweight, including the likes of Anthony Yeard. He knows he would likely be written off again, but he doesn't mind. He's comfortable with his experiences and his improvements. I just know the skills that I have, and ever since that Beterbiev fight, as you look at the Beterbiev fight now, and how much sharper and better I am as a fighter, and how I think more, he said, over time, my coach and I developed my fight game and made a good game plan. I learned so much, and I'm just such a calm fighter. And for the people that say, they talk about it and say this and that, I'm doing something I love and I'm getting paid good money for it, so I couldn't care less what they say. I'm willing to fight anybody. As you see, I fought Beterbiev, then I fought David Morrell when nobody wanted to fight him. I'm willing to fight anybody. Why not? I mean, that's why I am boxing. Now, that is the guy that is thought to be in line to fight David Benavides later this year. The guy is called Radivoje Kalajdzic. He's a guy that was topped first by Artur Beterbiev, and he's talking all good about Beterbiev and how he takes the soul out of you. He says he's not that a huge puncher, but he breaks you down slowly by slowly, those shots and those hooks and all those combinations, and eventually you can't be outboxing him, but he does slow you down bit by bit, and eventually he stops you. Guy has stopped each and every opponent he has faced. 20 fights, pro fights, he has stopped all the people, and he has good experience, went to the Olympics. He's fought so many amateur fights, and that's good experience for him there. And for all intent and purposes, you thinking that this Artur Beterbiev guy could stop anybody. If you looked at his fight, amateur fights with Alexander Usyk, you feel he has the beating of anybody. He has the beating of any style. It will be interesting to see how Dmitriy Bivol approaches this fight, and you just can't wait for this October 12th fight, where Artur Beterbiev will be up against Dmitriy Bivol for the undisputed at 175. Do place your comment in the comment section below and let us know how you feel all about this. I sign out. Peace.